So when I got that grade three during my January mocks, after my parents' evening in February, which is parents' evening that you guys are sort of happening in right now, and that's when you get to find that personal feedback and you get to really analyze what's happened, what's gone wrong, and really change it, or what's gone right, and continue and develop it. Or even if you're getting the nines, it doesn't mean just because you've gotten the nine for the grade boundary in your school, or you got a nine for the grade boundary of that year, or you got the best grade in your school. That doesn't mean that you are the best, because you've got other people from other schools who are doing far better than you. But you also got other people in other schools that are doing worse than you. So if you're at the nine mark, unless you're getting 40 out of 40, 20 out of 20, 12 out of 12, I wouldn't really focus on that too much. I'd more so say, okay, I'm probably at least gonna get a 7 if I continue at this rate with this work ethic, with these type of responses. So in my previous video, I just taught everybody and I, gave my advice about how you can improve, with GCSE English literature, most specifically poetry. So today I want to talk about again how I went from a grade three in my January mocks, the same year I took my GCSEs, and how a few months later, by the time, what was it, June, July came, I managed, to secure my 7 in time for my August results day.
Look how much sauce to you. You finna talk bad. You got that good, good. I'm finna spar day. She got some bad friends. She need to holler at me. I put them all down. I throw them.
So I already spoke about the whole poetry section, and I would genuinely start the poetry when I put out my video. And round about now is the time where you can start doing your English literature revision. And I'm going to, upload my videos, in sequence of how I did it, at what points, on what stages. I'm hoping to post more regularly, but as you guys know, I'm currently taking my A levels. So, my time is quite pressed and I do try to revise every day. And I do have lots of homework and essays to write. So I can't always prioritize making videos, but when I can, I will. So my first bit of advice, try hard with the coursework. Try hard with your English literature coursework. More often, especially for AQA, which is what I did, our task was to make a presentation. So if you try, okay, so technically your coursework doesn't put forward any marks for your overall GCSE English literature grade. However, having that distinction or that merit on your GCSE results paper, it could make you feel that much better. Like, wow, I really got a distinction, or I really got a merit. I personally got a distinction. So you have to find a topic that is interesting, and you have to be able to articulate and speak about your presentation, your topic, for at least 5 minutes and be very clear and confident. You need to know your PowerPoints. You need to know every single slide that you've done. And it's better that you have pictures on your slide and you don't have cue cards, and all the bits of, information is coming from your brain, and you're using the pictures to show the class, but also to prompt your brain. It's better that you do that than you have like 1,000 words or paragraphs on the board, because who wants to read paragraphs? It's a presentation. So you've got to think what is appealing to the person's eye and what shows that I can do things more independently and I don't have to depend on having information on the board or depend on cue cards in order for me to get that distinction. And yeah, by the end of it, when results day does come, you will be so happy that you got your distinction. It would make you feel so much better. It really would. It really does. In English literature, you get marks for knowing when about, a certain scene or a quotation is in the play. So it's not really about, oh, I need to know this, I need to know that. It's about knowing the mark scheme, which you don't need to know wholesomely, but it's about answering and sentencing your words in order to, get the marks from the mark scheme. So that includes saying, Lady Macbeth. Oh, I don't know any quotes, but Lady Macbeth breaks down, or you've got to embed the quotation. Say, not, oh, it's in Act One, Scene Two, but you've got to embed the quotation and say, this happened in this part of the play. I can't really explain it, but I'm gonna find something that I did during GCSE and I'm gonna pull it in this video right now for you. So it's important to know the context of your quotation in relation to the title of the question and whereabouts it is in the play. So if your question's talking about light versus darkness, or love or corruption, you've got to make sure that you're linking your paragraphs and you're linking your quotes directly to the question. So you can say, state what happened, and you can embed it and you get marks for that. You should really try to attend intervention sessions. I know that they're boring. I know sometimes they're not helpful, but sometimes they are when you've got a smaller, more focused group with people that are working at the same rate and the same stage that you're working at. And that way you don't have the pressure of the smart person in the class or stuff like that. As a smart person, if you're with other smart people, not that you feel dumb, but you got, you know, you can bounce off of other people's ideas, and you know, it's more challenging to you than being in a class where you're having to hold back, or you've gone past class, or you've got extension work, for example, all the time. And if you're not understanding something, talk to your teachers. That's what they're there for. You know, don't be afraid to ask questions. Sometimes you've got to think, am I asking the question I'm about to ask? Is that appropriate for the lesson? Is it appropriate for the time? Is it appropriate for the class? You know, you've got to think about these things, but definitely ask your teachers questions. Find them at break time, find them at lunchtime, arrange to meet them after school, and really like talk to them. And if you feel like your teacher isn't good or they're not really helping you, I know for certain that you probably have 4 to 5 other teachers within the department. Speak to another class's teacher. You know, sometimes speaking to other teachers or getting other perspectives also helps you as well. I thought that my English teacher was amazing, but I used to also go and do quotation analysis, I think every Tuesday, break time or lunchtime, with a different English teacher, and her ideas were also helpful. And then you get to draw ideas from here, from your own brain, and you come up with more perceptive thoughts and more perceptive responses and more, you know, what's it, juridiciously? I can't say the word. More juridiciously selected quotation. Make sure you learn relevant quotations. You don't have to pick out loads of quotations. If I was you, and if you were smart, you'd pick up quotations that can be used for multiple themes and multiple characters. For every character, you'd find quotations about how they're described in the beginning and how they're described by the end. You've got to think about their character development. That's really helpful when you do a comparison or a contrast within your paragraphs, because it shows that you're looking at the text as a whole and that you really know what you're talking about. If I was you, and this is what I did, I'd make sure you read all of your GCSE texts at least twice. I read Macbeth about 3 times. I read Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde twice. I listened to the audio book. So that's, again, listening to it other times, joining in when my quotations that I've selected, you know, are being said in the audiobook. You know, it's just little things like that that really helps you remember your quotations. It's about reciting them. It's about putting them on flashcards, going over them again and again and again. Do I know this? Do I not know this? Going over it in a different order. Asking your friends or your family to quiz you, but it's not necessary that they quiz you. You know, you could also go on Quizlet and play the little games. So yeah, make sure you know your quotations. And make sure you know your GCSE text inside out. The grade 9 students know the GCSE text inside out. They've done extra reading. It's not just going in class and, you know, okay, so my teacher's taught me this, so that's what it is. No, it's doing extra reading. It's finding books and stuff like that, which are around the subject. It's about looking at the context of the time, but not just the context that you Google Macbeth, Shakespeare, Elizabethan times, or whatever the times were, context. No, it's about looking at, of course it's about looking at the time, but it's also not looking at it directly in comparison to the play. It's about widening your knowledge and then bringing it back and refining all the new things that you've learned. Like, it's so important that you cement your knowledge of the play and you know it inside out. Because if you know it inside out and you've gone over it and you know that this bit is at that bit, or this bit that they've given me and the extract on the paper is before this bit, it really helps you. Just like how I said before, that developing your GCSE poetry skills for the poems that you're allowed to see really helps influence your skills for the unseen poetry. Always write about the writer's intentions. Write about the effects on the reader, like what effects it has on the audience. If it's a play, for example, what effect it has on the audience of the time, of an audience or the reader now, how that differentiates, and talk about the writer's intention. Why did the writer use this word, or why did they turn a, I don't know, a noun into an adverb, or why have they said it in this way, or why is this theme relevant, or what is the writer trying to say, what is Shakespeare's intentions? Always talk about that. That would give you a lot of marks and a lot of points. There's a really good Twitter page, and it's called GCSE_MacBeth. I don't know who runs the page, but the lady or the man has really good analysis and really good perceptive points and alternative points that you've never thought about, and that's really useful for English literature. You know the text and you know the play inside out. You will be able to draw analysis and comparisons. You'd be able to say, oh, this foreshadows this happening, or this is ironic because of that, or this bit where Macbeth, I don't know, sees the witches in Act 1, Scene 1, or they foreshadow, whatever, whatever. This bit mirrors his apparitions that he receives, or it mirrors his downfall that happens to Macbeth at the end. You got to really draw analysis from the beginning and the end, the beginning and the end, the beginning and the end. What part of the play did the quote come from? Embed it, embed it. And if you do things like this, this is what the top students are doing. I also did 2 quote analysis explosions a day. I call them quote explosions. So that's where I choose my selected and my relevant quotations, ones that apply for most themes and most, you know, characters, or are very interesting quotations that can be really analysed. I did a quotation analysis a day. Hopefully I have a picture to insert. So I really just thought about everything I could say about the quote. So not only this has helped me revise and recall my quotes, but it really helped me cement the analysis and like my different ideas, and it allowed me to rely on the power of my brain. But also, if you want interesting quotation analysis, then I'd go on genius.com and you search in Macbeth Act 1 Scene 1 or whatever you're studying, and it will come up with, you know, the different acts, and then it has analysis for different sentences, different phrases, different bits of the play, and it's really good as well. Themes. Can the same quote be recycled? Be recycled in what ways? What if the question was flipped? What if it's similar to what we did in class, but not exactly phrased how we did it in class? How can I use the quotation and adapt it to match the question? Yeah. Try to do an essay plan a week. Find an essay question. Stoke Newington School.co.uk has really good ones where they got like a list of questions. But you can Google GCSE Power and Conflict questions, Macbeth essay questions, GCSE questions. You can Google it and they will come up with a list. So once a week I would do an essay plan, and you know, how you do your essay plan depends on you. Everybody's different. Maybe you might want to do it how your teachers taught you to do it. You might have another way that works. So yeah, it's about making your essay plans, knowing the GCSE text inside out. It's about analysing your quotes, learning your quotes, knowing your context, and acting upon your teacher's criticism. So we're human, not everyone likes criticism, and not every person gives criticism, lays it out in the most productive form or in the most helpful or empathetic way. But at the end of the day, these criticisms, you're going to be criticized by the exam boards. Half of the examiners don't care. They don't know who you are. They don't care about who you are. They don't care about your handwriting. Do you know what I mean? They've got 1,000 papers to mark. Why is yours special? Show them why yours is special. And you can show them by literally showing all your knowledge, bringing in different ideas, you know, following my advice and all the things that I have said. It's helpful to use punchy sentence starters to get straight to the point. and to cut out the waffle. Avoid waffling the paragraphs. No one cares. No one's here to figure out what you meant to say, or do you know what I mean? No one cares. Cut out the waffle, get straight to the point, be concise, also be analytical, and reference the writer's intentions. And this is how you will go from a grade 3 to a 7, from a 4 to an 8, from a 5 to a 9, from a 2 to a 5. You know, this is how you improve. So I hopefully you found this video helpful. I'd appreciate if you could like, comment, and subscribe. If you have any questions, comment them down below. I will respond. Please don't hesitate to ask any questions. And if you enjoyed this video, I have even, I think, better advice for how to revise GCSE poetry, I think, because that's the part that I struggled with. So hopefully you can go to that video right now after this video. And thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. And until next time.